Hey everybody, thanks for being here. Today we're on the Clackamas River near Portland, Oregon with Jake Gregg and Josiah Darr from Clackacraft Boats and Nick Amato from Salmon Trout Steelheader magazine. Now if you want to learn how to catch more steelhead, stay tuned.
I'm Justin Wolf and this is Angler West Television.
With Mount Hood so visible from the Clackamas River, one might assume it to be the headwaters. But the Clackamas flows from farther south, near Mount Jefferson, before finally making its way to the Willamette River near Portland, Oregon. Historically, it's a legendary steelhead stream, but the construction of several dams slowed that action considerably. Today, the steelhead fishing is enhanced by the Oregon Department of Fish and Wildlife's Acclimation Pond program.
Well, my name is Todd Alsbury. I'm the district fish biologist for the Oregon Department of Fish and Wildlife, and we're here at the mouth of Foster Creek, which is the location of one of our acclimation ponds, where we acclimate fish to a specific water source other than our hatchery that's typically downstream from our hatchery to try to get fish to home back to an area where anglers have a better opportunity at targeting fish. And this has been one that's been very beneficial so far for both winter and summer steelhead. And we're hopeful that it will continue to improve this fishery and build upon, you know, something that's been pretty good for years, and we hope, you know, will be better in years to come that people will come and enjoy and take advantage of.
Yeah, the truck just unloaded about 25,000 winter steelhead that will now acclimate in this pond for 21 days before we release them into the Clackamas River. And then the idea is that these fish will come back home to this stream, Foster Creek, which is a tributary to the lower Clackamas, and then anglers will be able to target those fish from Foster Creek downstream. Foster Creek is closed, but these fish will hold in the Clackamas River for hopefully a couple of months before they're able to enter this stream. So that gives anglers a good opportunity to, you know, target those fish and harvest those fish, take them home, and you know, experience a good angling experience here on the Clackamas.
Juvenile winter steelhead. These fish are smolting right now, which imprints them to this water source, and in 2 years after maturing in the ocean, they will come back and be 6 to 12 pounds on average.
Today, Jake Gregg, Josiah Darr, and Nick Amato proved the acclimation pond program success with a beautiful catch of steelhead. The day started not so early in the morning by launching the power drifter just outside the town of Clackamas, near Portland, Oregon.
We'll see how she does here. Gonna go up the rapids with four guys in a boat. I think she'll do it just fine.
The Magnum power drifter is a new boat produced by Clackacraft Boats. Being a cross between a jet boat and a drift boat, it has obvious advantages on small to medium-sized rivers.
Over to the bank here.
Yeah. They've been getting them in this pool, kind of right on that inside seam, down to about the middle of the pool. Then it kind of shallows and flattens out, and the water's a little too quick. Okay, so we're going to use a combination of techniques today, probably some plastics, some drift fishing, and then maybe either float fish or drift fish some eggs here too. So I've got some steelhead eggs cured in ProCure, and these have been very effective at times. There's different types of leads you can use when you're steelhead fishing, but this Oregon Tackle 3/16 inch is one I like to use. You can use, it's hollow, so you can thread it onto your line, or what I like to do is punch a hole in it. So pinch it down like this. Real nice, and then just punch a hole right into it, and then I can use it with my swivel. So there you go, ready to for action. So one of the beauties with rigging like this is that oftentimes it'll, when you hang up, the sinker will pull right off through this thin lead right there. So that way you don't lose your entire rig. So it's pretty handy that way. There we go. So these are steelhead eggs from this river, and sometimes it makes a little bit of a difference. The fish really key in on them, so they work well.
You can see just how well.
The Northwest is loaded with great bass fishing, and Yamamoto has the right baits like the unbelievably effective Senko or a wide range of irresistible twin-tail grubs. For baits like the new Sanshu, try the twist-lock weighted hooks designed to Yamamoto specifications. Bass fishing is fun, and Yamamoto makes it easy to get started with versatile soft plastics that catch more fish than any other. Check out the Yamamoto website for lots of helpful videos on rigging and catching more fish. Nothing beats the Magnum Power Grifter by Clackacraft for fishability and performance. With unlimited customizable features, you can design your Magnum around your water and how you like to fish. And introducing the new Angler West Edition Center Console Magnum, the ultimate for comfort and control, the ultimate side drifting platform. Each Magnum is custom built by Clackacraft in Clackamas, Oregon. Call or go online today at clackacraft.com to learn more why the Magnum Power Grifter is right for you. It's a dangerous world down there. Protect your prop with Max Prop Saver. Perfect for any outboard up to 50 horsepower in rivers, lakes, or saltwater.
What this product is going to do is going to protect your prop from rocks, stumps, sticks. Also going to keep your line out of the prop while you're trolling on those tight turns, and keep your downrigger line out of the prop as well.
Learn more at PropSavers.com, where you can also find your local Prop Saver dealer. Welcome back to the Clackamas River. I'm Justin Wolf. We're with Jake Gregg, Josiah Darr, and Nick Amato, looking for our first fish of the day.
Well, we're here on the Clackamas River, obviously in Clackamas, Oregon, just outside of Portland. We're just above a park called Barton Park. We're set up doing a little bobber and jig fishing here. Today we're fishing for steelhead, hopefully some hatcheries here. We have a good chance of getting, obviously, catching a native fish as well, which we will release. I'm fishing here with my Lamaglass XMG50 9.6 great float rod. Caught a lot of fish with this rod. It's an awesome rod to catch a steelhead on.
Yeah, I think we covered this pool, and it's always a good idea to keep moving, find some fish. So we're gonna head down to the next one right below here for now.
Go try another hole here.
The next hole didn't produce either, so they decided to take advantage of the power drifter and start drifting to cover more water. We have a choice of either using the oars, the big motor, or the kicker motor, but we'll start with the oars.
In the water maybe there. I thought you taught me that trick, laying that line in the water. Pulls up forward like that.
Yeah.
So.
Probably, I don't know.
So that thing blowing back in the wind like that?
Yeah, when it's in the wind, you can't do it right. You just lay it down for a second and it'll...
Pulls up.
And keep your stuff going. Sometimes wind blowing upstream is a real pain for bobber fishing because it just hangs up your drift. But yeah, you lower that rod tip like that and it does the trick for you a lot of times.
Should I bomb that over at the bank a little bit more there, Nick?
I think we're going to run back up, aren't we, Nick? Are we to the bottom of this particular little?
No, I don't know. With the amount of time we have today, I think we should just keep fishing our way right on down the river. So the river's in nice shape, but it's up a little ways, a little higher than I like it, but the fish in these conditions will tend to travel along the edges, so we can focus our efforts there.
It's not bad for maneuvering, moving the boat around and stuff, even with four guys in here and a motor and all, you know, and a kicker.
They're definitely maxed out.
Yeah, but I'm having no problem keeping up, you know, where I want to be with that float. So when we're setting the hook on these bobber dogging rigs, because you got a little bit of belly in your line that accumulates, the most important part to get that hook set is to reel hard first and fast before, you know, get that slack out, get down to the fish, and then set the hook. If you just set the hook, you won't get a good enough stick and they just don't stay on. But if you reel down, get, you know, three or four good turns out of the handle, you'll hook most of the fish.
We've covered a lot of water that should hold fish, so it was decided to run back up, and this time Jake could control the boat to give Josiah some fishing time.
Got him.
Nice job.
Oh, it come off.
Oh.
Oh, that was a big fish.
Nice job though, wow, that's awesome.
Ouch, oh, that was a big fish. That was a really big steelhead.
Well, we're gonna go back and do that again. Yo, yeah!
Same exact spot, went back through there, same exact spot, same result. Jake, just kind of hang tight for a second.
I'm going to try. I'm at the, I am sitting at the bottom here. The bottom of his tail out.
There you go, perfect. Same spot. I love being able to rerun holes and come up and do it again, because once you find them, you can stay right on them.
Good job, Josiah.
Yeah, buddy.
Oh, beautiful fish.
I don't think this fish is going to be done. I've got a feeling he's going to take off again. Here, see if we get him right here.
Okay, I've got to lose a little bit.
Okay.
Nice. Maybe get back in the... Oh, yeah. Look at that fish, boys.
Look at that beauty.
I mean, that must have been within 2 feet of where the last one was, and it shot right to the bottom of the river again, and this time we were ready.
Go back up and drop anchor for a second, get all re-rigged, and get ready to get another one.
Some of these late season April winter steel, hatchery winter steelhead are so beautiful and bright and fresh, you can confuse them with the summer steelhead, especially right when you first hook them. But anyway, we're thinking this is a winter fish.
Plus it's got a max clip.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. So anyway, beautiful fish, just missed another one. I mean, what a day, nice and sunny out here. Boat's working great.
Definitely, it's definitely a team effort, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah, this is awesome.
Bobber dog and little yarn balls with bait on them. This is just a little red and chartreuse yarny. He came up and kind of bent my hook while we were fighting a little bit, but he came up and just smoked that little yarn ball, you know? One of thousands of fish that die every year because they ate a yarn ball. Gorgeous fish though, doesn't get a whole
beautiful,
lot prettier
than job.
That.
Hey everybody, thanks for watching this week's classic episode of Angler West. We're gonna go back to the Clackamas River and do some more steelhead fishing, but first I thought I'd show you around the Angler West store here in downtown Woodland, Washington. So if you're wanting to go fishing or learn more about fishing or just stock up on some great tackle, we've got everything you need right here in the store. Let's go take a look. So when you first come in, what you're gonna see is a really great selection of ProCure products. If you like ProCure, this is the place to be. We've got a lot of egg cures too. We just got in all the borax. So anything you need for ProCure, we probably have it here for you. And the bait wax. And through here, we've got some spinners and the Oregon Tackle School of Fish. Longer spinners, lots of hoochies. And these have been selling like crazy here in the summer. This the Acme Cast Masters and Rattle Masters. Little Cleos, got some good components here, beads and clevises and blades if you're into making your own stuff. This is a place to start for sure. Some not too kinky things. Very hot selling mats, pro fillet mats and the boards. Those are very popular. And if you're running a prop in the river without a prop saver on, or even out in the ocean or anywhere, because it's going to help keep the line out of your prop. But this is a great idea. And now fish field, lure and flasher bags. And if you're a surf perch fisherman, you definitely want the surf bag here. And we get some waders and things, but then also got a growing and very good selection of Yamamoto baits for bass fishing. If you're wanting to get into bass fishing, or learn more about it, I guarantee you, you come in here, we can help you be successful with the bass fishing. We've got some really good stuff. And down here, of course, the P line and all the fish field floats and the Oregon Tackle Unibobber sinkers. We got all those in stock. Then all the beads, like the fishing that you're seeing today in the show, you might, you know, we're using jigs and row, but beads can also be a good way to go. We got the good thirsty beads and soft, V&R soft beads, and some of the hard beads and brads, and then the Oregon Tackle steely bugs down here that hold scent really well. Got some mag lips, and then the Spro Rockstars and the Spro jigs. So this is very similar to the jig that you see working in today's show, this nightmare pattern. These are excellent if you want to get into jig fishing. I suggest you start with this one right here, the Spro Rockstar jigs. And then some great bass lures from Spro. This is a new one. Now where the, yeah, spin. That's the Spy Bait, the Spin John 80. This is personally one of my favorite new baits for the year, for sure. They just came out with these not too long ago, and I've had a lot of fun fishing those. And then on this side, we got the largest selection of Max Lure products anywhere in one single place, one single store. So if you're a trout, kokanee fisherman, walleye, you're gonna like this little section right here.
A lot of stuff for trout cooking, walleye and salmon. Got all the dodgers, sling blades, double D dodgers, big sling blades. And get into the fish flash, the Yakima bait, different sizes and colors, the Yakima bait fish flash. Got the spreaders and a very wiped out selection of spinning gloves. Spinning gloves are hard to come by these days. There's a shortage of them, but we got more coming. We'll have this fully stocked pretty quick. And then some great spin doctors and kokanee dodgers. Another thing that hard to get hold of right now, but as soon as more are available, we'll have this stocked up with all the colors you're used to seeing. And all the wigglers and the spinfish. This is one of the hottest selling products right now for sure, these Yakima bait spinfish. So it's on a lot of those. And some more of the wobblers. Pretty good selection of killer fish. And we have probably, you know, I don't know for sure, but I think we probably have the biggest selection of super baits anywhere around here anyway. So a big selection of all the different super baits and nets. We've got lots and lots of salmon, you know, salmon nets, steelhead nets, so to speak, and the kokanee nets. But we've got a lot of these in the back room too. So if you need a net, this is the place to be. We've got a lot of the cushion products. These are real popular with the albacore guys. You know, this will help you out reeling in those albacore for sure if you're fishing the Northwest here. And then P-line, twin tail squids, these squid skirts. My favorite for sure for fishing bottom fish and lake cod and bottom fishing and whatever. They're very effective, very durable, last a long time. You get a lot of fish out of each one. Come on in and check this out. But right now, we're gonna go back to the Clackamas River and catch some more steelhead.
We're on the Clackamas River just outside of Portland, Oregon. We're fishing a combination of jigs, beads, and eggs, and we've got our first fish in the boat that took a yarn ball, nearly identical to an Oregon tackle steely bug. And now we're looking for more.
We're pulling this little flat here. It's a pretty productive spot that we've fished a lot of times over the years. It's an acclimation point on the Clackamas River, so they let smolt go in here, so steelhead tend to hang in here, and you smell that creek they were released from, and this ends up being a pretty good spot to fish.
So this is a really simple rig. I'm just drift fishing some roe under a float. So I'm using a fairly small sinker, a fairly light line 8-pound test, and then a small sensitive float. I'm letting the float kind of drag along since I'm basically drift fishing, whereas with a jig I'd want it perfectly centered. With a jig, on the other hand, the jig's suspended, so you don't want it dragging on the bottom, so you want the float sticking straight up and down. And that way you'll know it's not, it's fishing at the right depth, which is usually about a foot right off the bottom. Dang, thought I had one there.
Fish on, guys. Sitting in the back of the boat here. The boys are down below here, below me. Just trying some different water and just did a readjust and cast it out here a little farther than I was fishing. The water's a little cloudy here. And sure enough, looks like another, if I could see it. Yep, another chrome hatchery.
Nice.
Oh, my bobber's gone. Get my bobber, Nick.
Nice job, bud. Grab that net for you. Get this guy scooped up.
So they're just sitting right out farther than we usually fish them, a little deeper. Yeah, I'm gonna get right up to you.
Watch those rod tips.
Oh, can't see anything there.
Here, go around.
Kind of a...
That way? There you go, bud.
Kind of an awkward position here. Back corner of the boat, all the rods are sticking out, but we'll get it. Keep it out of the motor, right there.
Sorry, I can't hit it. There's rods here. There you go. Pick his head up. We'll get him right here.
Yeah. Got him.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah, I just did a readjust. I was fishing real shallow in here, and it pays the kind of what Nick always tells me to do, just kind of keep gridding it out. And sure enough, just, that's, you know, gridding out, I got deeper, drop it a little bit, drop a little bit. And
beautiful winter steel. Looks like another winter. That thing's absolutely curling with lightning.
Brand new. They are moving around.
Take it down the floor, bud.
Oh. Nice.
Yeah, they're not settled in. These are brand new movers.
Yeah.
They don't get a whole lot chromer than that.
We've got kind of just two slots here. I was fishing real close to the boat, trying some real shallow stuff, and then I could see a little hump in the river there. I just fished on the other side of that hump, under a little green slot there, and readjusted, just went a little deeper, and sure enough, you know, made a cast and went about 10 feet, and whammo, fish on. Another beautiful hatchery fish.
Perfect.
Look at that, another jig bite.
Yeah, a little nightmare
nothing,
jig.
Nothing like that. So we just caught that beautiful fish there, and I'm going to put some more of this water-soluble fish oil on this jig. Works really well. Obviously, we just caught that nice fish with it. Fish on. Let's do it again.
Good job. Right on.
Oh, Josiah's got another one on.
Good job.
I was up at the boat and I walked down. Hadn't fished, you know, fished it for 30 minutes and then quit fishing it. And then walked back down here, give it another shot, and first cast. Nice, right out in front of me, right where we've casted 100 other times.
Just needed
the fish to come in here, you know.
I'm down there cooking lunch, you're down here catching fish.
Well, somebody had to catch a fish.
Yeah.
This one's got a little color. Pretty though.
Bring them on over here.
Here, let me get it, Jake.
Fish.
I'll get him. Just let me get his head turned. Fin, or is that a hatchery fish?
Yep, hatchery fish. That's a beautiful fish, Josiah.
Hey, bud. Yeah.
Good job, man.
That was cool. Yeah,
Join the Fish Alaska community and catch more fish. Visit our website at fishalaskamagazine.com or follow us on Facebook at Fish Alaska Mag or on Instagram at Fish Alaska Magazine.
And now, Angler West TV viewers get a special buy one, get one free offer on all subscriptions. Just visit fishalaskamagazine.com and enter code AW2021 at checkout.
Welcome back to the Clackamas River. I'm Justin Wolf. Josiah Darr has the lucky rod so far, with fish number two falling this time for a bead.
Fish. We got a fin, or is that a hatchery fish?
Yep, oh, hatchery.
Another hatchery fish.
That's a beautiful fish, Josiah.
Hey, bud.
Good job, man.
That was cool. That's the pre-lunch fish.
Pre-lunch fish. We needed that.
Well, that's
I love him colored up like that.
That one ate that bead. Yeah, isn't he pretty?
That bead too, huh?
Oh yeah, nice. That one smoked the bead. He's got that pretty orange stripe to him, and gosh.
This is awesome. It's a beautiful sunny day. You know, we didn't start really early. We're kind of taking our time and fishing casually. We've already hooked 4 steelhead. I mean, amazing. So it's a heck of a lot of fun.
And I think our sausages are burning down there.
Oh no, we better go.
Go down there and check it out. Little shore lunch here. Pretty simple, a couple packets of dogs, a couple buns, and voila.
So we're all doing a little bit different stuff today. Nick's drift fishing right now. Jake's up there floating the jig. I'm bobber dogging the same way we were set up when we were moving. Same setup as a, you know, fish when I'm out of the drift boat. I got a chop bobber, little three-way with a little snap on it, a Stony River sinker, and then it goes to a leader down to my yarn ball with a little cluster of secret Nick Amato eggs, and then a little dropper to a little bead. And one of the things I started to do with the beads, I kind of like, But we've been using a little bit of bloody tuna anise gel on the beads. It's kind of nice. It stays on there real good. And I can actually put it on my bobber stop and it stays in there. But the gel works out great. But yeah, it's been a deadly setup. Hopefully we can bounce our way into one or two more fish today. But it's already been an awesome day. We got three or four good friends and beautiful, beautiful, beautiful weather. It's tough to beat.
Hey, Josiah, you're done, man. You got your limit.
Woo! I forgot. I got to quit, don't I? Oh, man. All right. Well, that's what the rig we've been using. I just realized I got to put mine away now and sit around and watch. Good thing Jake made hot dogs. And nothing else to do but sit around and eat hot dogs. Shoot, I am done. Bummer. It's too nice to be done.
In the future, with help from the expanding acclimation pond program, limits should be more common on the Clackamas.
These acclimation programs are great because it's spreading the fish throughout the river. These are hatchery fish, so everybody can keep them, and just make it for a great fishery, and it gives a lot of angler opportunity. So what I understand is they're going to increase the plants of hatchery, summer steelhead into the lower river, which is great because even though there's a great return and a great plant, they're all going up to the hatchery, thereby, you know, just giving the anglers a shot at the fish for a few days, and then they just stack up there. Now the fish are going to be spread out, and it's going to be much better fishing, for sure.
Good job.
I'm going to go right over here in that little cove here.
Whoa, another nice chromer.
Yeah, buddy.
That was fun.
Okay, let's see if we can
up and back. Okay. Got him.
Nice.
Carl's going to be happy. That's a nice brute there. That's a nice fish.
Looks like another hatchery fish. Heck yeah.
It's a buff.
Hey, good job, Nick.
Nice.
He gave me a face full in the net. Hold on, bud.
All right, that was fun.
That was a good one. Maybe we'll get to chase that one down the rapid and everything. All the same. Hey, get their noses the same height. There you go.
For the Clackamas, that's a great day of fishing. And today, the boat really made a big difference. The Magnum Power Drifter is lightweight but stable, and it only takes a 30-horse jet to make good time heading upriver. And the ability to drift fish the same runs over and over again is obviously a huge advantage, and enabled several of our fish today. If you would like to learn more about the Magnum Power Drifter, contact Jake or Josiah at Clackacraft Boats. Episode of Angler West TV. You know, it's only with the sponsor support that the show is made possible, so please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.